If you see my script, trust me, what I'm going to do right now isn't scripted. It just happened 30 seconds ago. Right? So when I was seeing the theme, what's cooking? You know, I had this really big obsession for WWE. So for those of you who know who Rock the Dwayne Johnson is, please can you lift your hands up? And if I'm right, he does something like this. Finally, if you can tell what the Rock is cooking. So, getting Rock in my mind and realizing I was a Ghostbuster today, I did my own version of this. Finally, if you could smell what the Toastmaster of the day is cooking. And this is something that I wanted to do. You know, I was thinking, so what's cooking, Toastmasters? What's really cooking in your head, or what's cooking around you? In the 1970s, most of the newspapers had amazing or catastrophic headlines. It said something like this: 100 people die of hunger, 1,000 people die of floods. And in 2015, you know what it says? 1,000 people die because of noodles. Welcome to reality. Here we are, where no typhoon, no flood, no earthquake, no natural calamity, but just 10 rupees and 2 minutes is sufficient to cook you up a ready ticket to heaven. Is it really a marketing gimmick, or are they trying for a comeback? Just like Dairy Milk did, if you know your history for the last 10 years. Coming to Toastmasters, if you have a certain standard or a certain level, you should know how and when to speak and how to listen. If you do so, your success will increase proportionately, said that great man, Ralph C. Mellon. This man was one of the biggest people, or I should say the hidden person, for all of us to come here to this meeting. We are here because of his vision. He conducted the first meeting in Santa Ana, California, in the year 1924, in the YMCA building basement, on the October 22nd. This man knew what he wanted to do. And the first meeting, in fact, was conducted in 1904, an unofficial meeting. And today, here we are because of that one man's hard work, that one man's vision. And coming to Toastmasters, and for the benefit of the guests, Toastmasters meeting has three sections. The first one is the prepared speeches, the second one is the table topics, and the third one is the evaluation. Here, in the first segment, that is the prepared speech, we have various speakers who've been preparing over a few days over a particular speech, and then they come and deliver, preparing in advance. In table topics, some of the speakers are handpicked and given topics on the spot. It's basically impromptu speaking. And the last and the most crucial part of Toastmasters is the evaluation. The evaluation isn't just done the way the evaluator wants it to be. He has to be subtle, he has to be accurate, he should know what he's pinpointing. And that is done to perfection. And after Toastmasters, we come up with roles. And today, I would like to call upon one such Toastmaster who's always been this person who's welcoming, who's very warm. And this person is a great fan of music, and he's one of those people whom you can approach with any problem at any point. person has been a guiding light to many speakers, and I think he was the first person I spoke to in my first Toastmasters meeting. So please give it up to the General Evaluator, Prakash Francis.